So nearly three dozen people in Illinois, Minnesota, and Wisconsin have been hospitalized recently after vaping. Some of those patients have been diagnosed with severe lung disease. CNN's chief medical correspondent, Dr. Sanjay Gupta, here to explain. Sanjay, what's happening?
Well, you know, it's interesting. These mainly young patients showing up at these hospitals, and they got these symptoms of shortness of breath, of cough. You can take a look at the various things that they come in with. Fever very much looks like a bad pneumonia or something, and the patients are getting treated for that, oftentimes with antibiotics. And you know what happens? They're not getting any better. Doctors start to look a little further into this and say, is there something that's tying these patients together? And what they find is that all the patients had a history of vaping recently. So this is the association that the medical teams in these places are fixated on. Take a look at the map of where this is happening. And the geography is a little bit important here. The number of cases in Wisconsin, 4 in Minnesota, 12 in Wisconsin, 13 more under investigation, 6 in Illinois. The map shows you where these are. And if you dig a little deeper into that, you find that it's actually clustered in a somewhat similar geographical area, even more than the map sort of indicates there. So this is an investigation now. What exactly were they vaping? Is this related to these lung injuries? That's what the investigators are focused on.
But, I mean, Sanjay, what's counterintuitive for people who think that vaping is safer than smoking is why is this happening with vaping and not with cigarettes?
Yeah, well, and you know, so far it's still an association, although a pretty strong one. There's a couple of things I think to point out. First of all, with vaping itself, there are these liquids called e-liquids, which are the liquids that are heated up, and there's been some concern for some time that those liquids could in fact be causing injury, could cause injury to the lungs. But I think there's another point here, and that is that when you start to talk about vaping, people are oftentimes putting other substances into these vaporizers as well. I just learned this morning, if you put marijuana, for example, in that, that's called dabbing, and it's sort of an indicator that people can be vaping all sorts of different things. So the question is, if they prove this association to be correct, was it the vaping itself? Was it the vaporizer itself? Was it the e-liquid? Or was it something else entirely that was placed in the vaporizer? And that's going to be a big question as well, because that's happening quite commonly.